Hello everyone, I'm Soumya Sharma. I've secured rank 9 in this year's civil services examination. This was my very first attempt. I graduated only last year from National Law University, Delhi in June 2017. My optional was law as well. Another thing about me, I have hearing disability and I wear hearing aids to hear and to converse. I really hope my story helps and motivates most of you out there, and especially those people who have some or the other disability, because I believe let nothing stop you from achieving your goal. I really hope this video helps, and here it is. It wasn't a very smooth journey for me at all. I saw my own share of ups and downs through it all, but now after seeing the result, the journey truly has been worth it. So I wrote the entire 1 week of the mains examination was the 1 week when I had very high viral fever. So this was the part where I questioned why this is happening to me and whether I'll be able to do it, but I did not give up. So that was the part of the journey which was very challenging for me. Apart from that, the journey was very nice. I started preparing just 4 months before the prelims on 19th Feb 2017 is when I took the decision to give the exam. So overall, it has been a wonderful journey for me, and I feel really grateful to be here and to tell you about my journey. A couple of things. First of all, you need to believe in yourself. That is extremely important, because when you look at the numbers, you have some 12 lakh people are filling up the forms, out of which some 5 to 6 lakh are appearing, and in the final list you only have around 990 people or so who get the name. Because it will give you this inner motivation and strength, and you will be able to keep on studying, putting in effort, which is very important. One is that, and the second thing which is very important is sincerity and dedication. Whatever you are studying, it needs to be done with utmost sincerity and dedication, because if you're not being sincere, the only one who is going to lose out is you and no one else. So you need to be very honest and very sincere with your studies, and I think these are the most important things for any aspirant, for any exam in fact, not just UPSC, but for any exam. Guidance, and the right guidance at the right time, plays a very crucial role in any aspirant's preparation. So for me, when I started preparing for this exam, the first thing that I did was I read up the strategies of previous year toppers, and these are available on the internet. Learn from the success of people and also learn from the failures of people, so that you should know what are the things that you should totally avoid while preparing for this exam. Apart from that, if you know people who have cleared this exam successfully, make it a point to stay in touch with them, talk to them and take personalized guidance from them, and that will also help you a lot to clear this exam. So current affairs forms a very important part of the syllabus, not just for prelims but for mains as well. It also will help you significantly in your essay and the interview. But specifically for this examination, the way I went about it was, so before prelims I was reading The Hindu plus one monthly magazine which covers all the current affairs in a very concise format. This plus Yojana and Kurukshetra as well. These magazines will be sufficient. But after prelims for mains, what I did, I added the Indian Express to my list. It's very easy to cover both newspapers in one day if you have a sufficiently good reading speed, and because news will overlap, but you can just read the editorials and the striking out parts from these two newspapers, and I think these will help you. Before the interview, what I did was I added two more newspapers to my list. That was the Times of India, because it covers all the local news which can be asked in the interview. And also, I started reading the Economic Times during the time of the budget. So all of this helped me cover this current affairs in a very comprehensive manner. So answer writing, first of all, I joined test series and I used to practice writing answers for all the papers. That is one. Second, your content is extremely important for your answers. So in my answers, I did not make any diagrams. However, I have still scored the third highest marks in GS this time. So I feel your answers depend on the content more than the diagrams and the flowcharts that you're making. So if your content is good, make sure that you present it in a nice manner. The formatting of your answers, like make paras, then shift to bullets, then again para, bullet, it makes your answers look nice. Apart from that, the very basic thing is that your answer should have three parts: an introduction, a very small introduction, relevant to the question, the body in which you make the arguments, counter arguments, and the conclusion. The conclusion could be in the form of a suggestion, a way forward, or just a simple conclusion, and this makes your answer look good. So that's all about answer writing. Law as an optional subject is quite comprehensive. The syllabus for law is quite a lot. You'll have to study many books. However, law helps you a lot because if you are studying law as an optional, your understanding of GS2 would be very clear and it will help you with that. So if you take law as an optional subject, you should know that it will end up taking a lot of your time. It was easy for me because I had studied law for 5 years at NLU Delhi. So I had my notes from college time, which I used to refer to. But if you're taking law as an optional, you should know that making your own notes for this optional is important. So for those of you who are taking law as an optional subject, I have written my entire comprehensive strategy and book list on my blog. The link is provided to you here. So you can just refer to my strategy and I hope it helps you. So when I started preparing for this exam, one thing was very clear to me that essay and ethics, if I focus on these two papers, I can get a good rank. And it finally did happen with me. I secured 160 marks in the essay paper this time. But I would still tell you that essay is one paper which can definitely help you get the service of your choice and even the cadre of your choice. A lot can depend if you write a good essay. So please don't take this paper lightly. Do try practicing essay writing because it will help you and it will also help you channel your ideas better. And that helps even in your general studies answer writing. So do focus on essay. My message to all you aspirants out there would be that first of all, please believe in yourself. That kind of confidence is very important. Secondly, choose your sources wisely. Don't do the same topic from 2-3 different books. Stick to some good, trusted sources and revise them again and again. Revision is very important. Also, do not miss out on test series because test series is what gives you the whole idea of how you're going to perform in the exam. So these three things are important, and also please do take care of your health also. Well, studies is important, but just do take care of your health, and I wish you all the best for this exam. Thank you. Byju's played an important role in my preparation. Since I did not join any traditional coaching classes, I relied heavily on online content. I specifically remember having prepared geographical indications from the interactive PDF which was there on Byju's website, and many other topics Byju's has made available on the website, and that helped me for the prelims and the mains part. Apart from that, I joined mock interviews at Byju's for my interview preparation and to talk and to answer in front of the esteemed panel. That was also a good learning experience for me. Overall, Byju's has helped me in many ways in my interview preparation, and thank you for that.